please, you better just stand up. You solemnly swear or affirm the testimony you're about to give in the matter now pending shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God. Have a seat, please, sir. So, Judge, your name?
Thurmond Atkinson.
And your employment with the sheriff's
office. I'm sorry, what was your first name, sir?
Thurmond Atkinson.
And you're employed at Dawson County Sheriff's Office, is that correct?
Correct.
And what is your rank?
Captain.
All right, and you're captain over which division?
Criminal Investigations.
And what are your duties?
Manage the whole division and our investigations.
Now, how many officers or deputies are within your division?
Including myself, 8.
Y'all have been kind enough to prepare an organizational chart for me for your department, correct?
Correct.
All right. So, again, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Sorry. We don't have a corporal as of yet.
All right. And it's just, is that a position that's to be filled?
It needs to be filled, yes.
Okay. All right. So, we start here, you're the captain of investigation, right. Is that right? All right. And, Captain, I think you sent over some background information, but can you tell the judge your background experience and education, please?
Okay, been a police officer for 33 years. Have approximately 4,500 training hours. Estimate being around 45 or 50 college credits.
And what police department, sheriff's office have you worked in the past?
Started Cherokee County. From there, Forsyth County, retired from there and came here in 04.
All right. When you came here in 04, did you immediately go over to the investigations division of the sheriff's office?
Yes, straight into investigation.
Been there since?
Other than retired for, I think, a couple years or so, then came back.
Okay. They keep bringing you, do they? Okay. Tell the judge what functions your division performs. Sheriff's office.
Okay, we're over narcotics. Right now, evidence custodian, but however, that position is not filled at this time through investigations. Also, we're minus admin person, which investigators has to do all that themselves. Property crimes, just about everything, forgery, property, sex crimes, homicides, whatever comes across.
Okay. And are you able to assign the officers that are listed here within your division to a specific type of crime?
No.
So all the investigators have to pitch in where needed?
Yes, sir. Correct.
Based upon your knowledge, experience, and training, is that unusual, Captain?
Yes, sir, it's unusual.
Okay, why? In what way?
Well, if you have someone, if you will, that specializes in maybe one area, they're going to do a lot better job, more thorough at it than shooting them everything, whatever comes across.
And why don't you assign to the specific type of crime? Why don't you assign investigators based upon the specific type of crime?
Yeah. Okay, you say
which? Why don't you do that?
Okay, we don't have enough help.
Okay.
No, sir.
Now, you believe y'all need more investigators then, is that
yes,
correct?
Yes.
Now, are you familiar with any recommendations or standards for the investigation divisions of a sheriff's department?
Yes, or what? We need this other investigator very badly because in the drug unit, you can't just put one person out here alone working drugs. You have to do surveillance, which we don't have the manpower to do that. In order to do surveillance right now, let me say this, as we speak, we have 6 cases, confidential informants, has provided us information that we need to get on some major drug cases, but there's not time to do it. We currently have 10 child molestations that are being worked right now. And I simply cannot pull investigators off of something like that, have them doing surveillance on a bunch of drug dealers.
Okay. And when you talk about surveillance.
Yes, sir.
Tell the judge what you mean by that.
Okay. Let's say a confidential informant tells us, hey, that this address over here is a lot of cars in and out all the time, drug activity. Okay, a property worked at, you'd want to put a couple people out there in the woods or wherever, surveillance in this place, writing tag numbers down, doing some background investigation, where these people live, where they're coming from. Maybe set up a roadblock, determine whatever leads you to go. But what we have to do right now in a situation like that, not having the manpower doing the surveillance, we have to get to see it, what confidential informant, maybe to, we'll wire them up, let them make a couple, two or three controlled buys from that house, and then go in with a search warrant two or three buys later and take them down. But again, if we could work it the way I just told you, the proper way to work it, then we could make a lot more drug arrests. I mean, and get the stuff off the streets, because meth is cheap now, it's way down. It's around $120 for an 8-ball out the street now, an eighth of an ounce. That's about a 5-day supply approximately for a user. It's cheap now, about $120. It's going on up, and just heroin's hitting out there. We had two people in their 20s, I think it was a male and female, just last year, overdose on heroin in Dawson County.
Do you see property crimes also related to drug crimes?
Yes, sir. All this goes together, and again, I just told you my yearly experience. I failed to tell you, 21 of these years have been in CID investigation.
Yes,
sir. And all that's related. All this drug stuff is related to property crimes on and on. I've interviewed, I know, hundreds of drug suspects over my years. Yeah, man, I went there and pawned it. They pawned and stole the stuff to buy drugs with. They'll steal guns and trade guns for them. They turn up another search warrant. It goes hand in hand. I can tell you now, if that drug trade is busted down, property work, lower down, you're going to see these property crimes come down to it out. They're in jail, they're not out here doing it.
And the proper surveillance, as you've described it, for a drug investigation, does that, in your experience, lead to more arrests than the arrests you're able to make now?
Absolutely, yes, sir. And not only that, at times when there's not surveillance going on with drug activity, in between those gaps, let's look at all these entering autos we have around Chesapeake up on the north end of Wapak. I mean, on, I don't know how many, 60 or 80 cars I think it's hit up there. But we have some kind of surveillance that I'm talking about. I could also put a couple of people on something like that, major going on. But again, we have to prioritize things, and of course, drugs is important to get them out of here. But we can't very well, somebody's kid's been molested. Hey, y'all just wait on that, we're gonna work drugs. Can't do that.
And so when you go to work a major crime such as a child molestation, tell the judge what happened. You started there, you started to go down that path, so you have to pull your investigators over to
yes.
help with that?
Yes, sir, because you're talking about forensic interviews on these children, has to go to Hall County, and one child can be up to a child investigator up maybe for a half day. You look at drive time going and coming, and an interview that the psychologist does up there. And if it's two or three kids, and a lot of times it is, it can be one day and go back the next day. You have to get these things done to get a prosecution in court and work the case correctly.
All right. And you said y'all don't have an administrative person.
No, we do not.
So does each detective write their, prepare their own reports and deliver those reports?
Absolutely, they have to do it all themselves. Yes.
Were you familiar with that being the same circumstance in other places where you've worked in the past, Captain?
Yes, I've been through it when there's no admin person, but I can tell you, you know, with admin person, that's what they do is do all this administrative stuff to free up the investigator to do the police work.
And what about training? Are your detectives and investigators able to obtain training and
yep.
to the rate that you believe to be appropriate or get their proper training?
They're getting training, but not what I call proper training. Proper training would be going to where The best places that can offer the best kind of specialized training are, but again, Cape Verdeville scattered a lot of people for going for training off for lengths of time, all these cases like this.
When you have a major case, do the investigators have to stop all other investigations they're doing to work those major crimes?
Yes. Absolutely. In other words, if we got a child molestation or something, rape or something like that going, well, we got to stay on top of that versus maybe, for instance, somebody's outfield is broken into in a chainsaw. So again, that's crime and everything too, but kind of have to go with the worst thing and get on it.
Does that delay prosecution of those other crimes?
Absolutely.
Does sometimes it prevent prosecution of those other crimes?
Could very well do it because witnesses fade away. If you've got a major, if you got whatever kind of crime you got, if there's any witness around, the sooner you get on this thing, the better. Because witnesses disappears, they forget. I mean, you want to get on.
The number of calls or the number of requests for investigative assistance from your division, is that increasing? From 2015?
Yes, sir, I have some numbers here. There was 399 cases assigned investigations. 2016, 348. Last year, 484.
You had the same number of people that you previously had, is that correct? Other than the corporal position?
Okay, I'm not sure if it's the same number over. I came over October in 16. Oh, there's, I can't answer it.
Right.
I was there prior.
But since time you've been there, I guess, would be a better question.
Yes, sir. It's been now a couple, several that's left, so I can't say this number is exact the whole time.
All right. Now, handles your evidence custodian work now?
Right now, Sergeant Christopher Murphy is handling it. He was in investigations, I think a month or two ago, somewhere along there. He got promoted to lieutenant, and he was transferred to Captain Ray Goody, the training unit.
Okay.
And he is handling evidence through over there correctly right now is what he's doing.
All right. And how much of the person's time would that take, but they otherwise would be serving as an investigator?
Well, it would take a whole time because when he was with me, I want to say about 60% of his time was tied up with that evidence.
Okay.
Evidence room.
All right. Captain, what is the impact, as you've described, not having a sufficient number of people upon the ability to preserve the peace and enforce the law by the Dawson County Sheriff's Office?
Investigators are working these crimes, but the way I see it, some of the metal men getting by, if you will, versus having the proper manpower that can work them the way they should be worked in a timely manner.
And can you even determine how many cases are assigned to each investigator?
Approximately anywhere from, I'd say, 12, 14, 18, somewhere in that category for the investigator.
All right. And is that 12 to 14 per month, or do you just make sure they have that many?
No, that's about for a long time, somewhere along that area is what they have.
And is that a mix of property crimes and personal crimes?
Yes.
Do you have a way to break that out by investigating?
I don't know how.
Yeah.
Those documents would end up breaking.
And if you did, would that change based upon what came in tomorrow? If you did have that number, would it change based upon?
I don't think we're the same thing, about that many cases for each one.
Right, but breakdown between personal and property, would that change per investigator based upon what comes in the door tomorrow?
No, it would still be a mixture of whatever comes in.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Let me ask this. Does Dawson County have any kind of arrangements with the GBI or anybody else to assist with, you got maybe a complicated murder case or something like that?
Yes, sir.
But to bring in somebody else to help with manpower, expertise, or does Dawson County do it all?
No, sir, we can request for the GBI to come in and assist, but usually when we do, it's something along the lines of a homicide that's occurred here, and maybe the crime flows into other counties, this sort of stuff like this.
I understand.
No, sir, it's not practice that we would call the GBI just because, hey, we got a bunch of burglaries and we've got these stales, so how about coming to help? That's not what really, that they would want to do. It's a situation like I just explained, something like a homicide, something like that.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I had one other thing. Is your division have any responsibility as it relates to the sex offender registry?
Absolutely.
First of all, tell us what that is.
Okay, sex offenders, they are required by Georgia law to be registered. Once they're declared to be a sex offender, we have 37 sex offenders that lives in Dawson County. 13 works here. Now, once a month, these are divided among my investigators. Once a month, they have to check their assigned sex offenders, go to that house, verify that they still live there, that they still got the same motor vehicles, and talk to neighbors, make sure a bunch of kids not hanging around, just make sure they're doing right. Now, this takes up a lot of time to do that. It's done on a monthly basis. And also, when they go out to check on these sex offenders, there's many times they come back and have to go back a second, third time. The reason for that, not at home, they're not there, we talk to neighbors, but we have to make sure they're still living. Because if not, they're looking at a felony charge for violation of the sex offender law by looping up there.
Thank you.
And the 13 that works here in Dawson, we have to verify that employer to make sure they're still working where they say they are.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Captain.
Yes, sir.
No questions, John.
You wish this witness released?
Sure, sure.
Yes, any objections? You release me if I can catch this matter. Where do we stand?